Alright, thanks for watching and welcome to the culmination of the series on orthogonality. Namely, today I will cover Fourier series. And this is really the video I've been working on for the orthogonality. It's just to do this video, so get ready. Because at first, this does not seem like an orthogonality problem. And what is our problem here? Given a certain function, so given f, continuous, you know, on the interval minus pi to pi, okay, what we want to do, we want to find WTF, so want to find am and bm, so coefficients, such that f of x is sort of equal to, and I explain why it's a sarcastic equal, okay, to the following series. M equals to 0 to infinity of am cosine of mx plus bm sine of mx. In other words, what we want to do, we want to find coefficients am and bm such that any function that's continuous from minus pi to pi can be written as a series of those cosine and sine. In other words, what we really want to do is, given a certain function f, whatever that is, so this is f on minus pi and pi, we want to approximate it with squiggly lines. So we want to write it like this, where those squiggly lines are the sum of am cosine plus bm sine. And this thing is so important, it's called the Fourier series, so named after Fourier series. And in some video I did on separation of variables, I explained why, you know, this might be very useful. Because at some point we had a function and we wanted to write it in terms of signs, and then we didn't really know what to do with that. Okay, and as I said, this has to do with orthogonality, and you might say, how in the world does it have to do with orthogonality? Well, here's a fact. This thing here, those coefficients, if you take all of them, if you take, consider this set B, which is a set of cosine mx and sine of mx, where m ranges from 0 to infinity. So this set, which is, if you want, cosine of 0x, sine of 0x, cosine of x, I guess 1x, sine of 1x, etc., etc. If you take this huge set, it turns out it's orthogonal. So, in fact, it's a very nice set. Orthogonal, so ta-da! You know, it brings us back to our orthogonality section. And one little thing, this is of course zero, but if you ignore this zero part, it's in fact an orthogonal basis. So it's actually a basis of functions, but just one thing. So when we talk orthogonality, well, we need a dot product, but here the dot product between f and g is just the integral from minus pi to pi, f of x, g of x, dx. Okay, so, and in fact, it is a dot, you know, it's very similar to the finite dot product, because here we take products, and then we take a sum. So it's like the sum of a and bn. And by the way, just in case you're curious, why is it orthogonal? Well, strictly speaking, what you have to do, you have to show that if you dot cosine mx and cosine nx, you get 0 for m not equal to n. If you dot sine of mx and sine of nx, you get 0 from m not equal to n, and you want to show that if you dot cosine mx and sine of nx, you get 0 for any m and n. And this has to do with, I won't show it, but it has to do with those formulas. If you take, you know, cosine of A times cosine of B, that's the same thing as 1/2 cosine of A plus B plus cosine of A minus B. So it's like a reverse sum formula. And if you take that and you integrate, then you do get 0 in those cases. And you know, there are other formulas as well. But we don't, this is not why we're here today. Here, we rather want to ask ourselves, given that it's orthogonal, how does that solve our problem? And for this, I would like to remind you the Hugging formula. So recall from maybe the first video. If, let's say you have an orthogonal set, UVW is orthogonal, and X equals to AU plus BV plus CW, then in fact, there's a nice formula of A, B, and C. Because then, what is A? You hug X with U, and then U hugs itself. Remember the happiness formula? And then B is x dot v over v dot v, C equals to x dot w over w dot w. Well, it turns out it's the same thing here. So if f is the sum from 0 to infinity of am cosine of mx and bm sine of mx, because we know those are orthogonal, we actually get the formulas here. Namely, to get AM, AM, sarcastic equal, so AM then equals to F dot cosine of MX over cosine of MX, dotted with cosine of MX, and BM is f dotted with sine of mx over sine of mx dotted with sine of mx. And therefore, if you use the definition of the dot product here, it's integral from minus pi to pi of f of x cosine of mx over integral from minus pi to pi of cosine mx times cosine mx. Dx, dx. That's for AM, and for BM, it's the same thing, but with sines. Integral from minus pi to pi of f of x sine of mx, dx, over integral from minus pi to pi as sine of mx, dx. Ta-da! So, with orthogonality, we solved our Fourier problem, and in fact, there's more. Those integrals, again, if you use, I guess, the angle, you know, the double angle formulas for sine and cosine, it's always equal to whatever value you find here. So it's here, in this case, it's pi. So the answer becomes, in this case, 1 over pi integral from minus pi to pi, f of x cosine of mx dx, and for bm, that's 1 over pi integral from minus pi to pi f of x sine of mx dx. Ta-da! And in general, it's like, you know, you get the sine of pi mx over the interval over t, and then this becomes t, and that's 1 over t. Very neat. In fact, let's do a quick application of this. Also, I mean, there is an issue about 0, but, you know, m equals to 0, but I'll resolve this in a second. So, let's, for example, do f of x equals to x. f of x equals to x. So we want to write x as the sum from m from 0 to infinity of am cosine of mx plus bm sine of mx. Okay, let's first do again the case m equals to 0 first, because that's sort of the peculiar case. Well, then a0 becomes x dotted with cosine of 0x over cosine of 0x dotted with cosine of 0x. And but this is really the integral from minus pi to pi of x times 1. So x dx over integral from minus pi to pi of 1 times 1 dx. But here comes an important remark for our next video. This function x, it's an odd function. And if you integrate an odd function over minus pi to pi, you get 0. So on the one hand, you have 0. On the other hand, and that's super important in general, 1 times 1 is 1. Okay. Very important. But if you integrate 1 from minus pi to pi, you get 2 times pi. And so this is like a slight modification. If you have, you know, the case a0 is 1 over 2 pi times integral of f. And then, well, let's also do b0. Well, look, technically, b0 is x dotted with sine of 0x and then sine of 0x dotted with sine of 0x. But here in this equality, okay, sine of 0x is 0. So no matter which value of b0 you choose, you still get the same series. And so just by convention, set b0 equals to 0. So that's the only problem with the case, you know, the 0 case. But then the rest, we can just do it, you know, in the same way. And so now for all the other cases, for everything else, there's MasterCard. So for m equals to 1, dot, 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 then am equals to, again, x dotted with cosine of mx over cosine of mx dotted with cosine of mx. That's integral from minus pi to pi of x cosine of mx dx over integral from minus pi to pi of cosine squared mx dx. This, no matter what Fourier problem you do, will be equal to this value here. So 1 over pi. And this one, very important, this is an even function. This is an odd function, and so odd times even becomes odd. And if you integrate an odd function on the symmetric interval, you get 0. So in fact, the cosine coefficients are 0, okay? Which sort of makes sense, because x is an odd function, so an odd function you'd like to write in terms of sine. But now for the sines, that's the important thing. So bm is f dotted with sine mx over sine mx dotted with sine mx, and that's integral from minus pi to pi x sine mx over integral from minus pi to pi sine squared mx. This thing on the bottom equals to whatever number is here. So pi, 1 over pi. And well, this one, I guess, calls for integration by parts, or you can also use this tabular integration I did in another video. So this is like, I guess, u prime v. So uv is minus cosine of mx over m, and then v is x. That's one. minus pi to pi. And then, by the way, here you can also use this odd and even thing, because this is an even function, so it's 2 times the integral from 0 to pi. But let's not do that for a second. And then minus, so uv prime, which is integral from minus pi to pi of cosine, minus cosine of mx over m dx. And so we have 1 over pi times disjunct. So pi times minus me, so cosine of pi m over m. Okay. And then minus, okay, minus pi times minus cosine of minus me over m. Okay, so that's good. And then you still have the plus 1 over pi. And then you have plus plus here, so it becomes integral, I guess, if you want, minus pi to pi of cosine of mx over m dx. And then let's see how we can simplify this. Those pi's cancel out, so we have minus cosine of pi m, which is minus 1 to the m, over m, and then so the 3 minuses, so it becomes minus, and then the pi's cancel out, and you still have minus 1 to the m over m. So we have 2 of them. And then for this one, well, you can calculate the integral 1 over pi sine of mx over m. Very good. From minus pi to pi. But look, if you evaluate this, you get sine of pi m and sine of minus pi m. So all those things are 0. And in the end, you're left with minus 2 times minus 1 to the m over m. And you get 2 times minus 1 to the m plus 1 over m. Ta-da! So in the end, you find that your function x is written as follows. So x is sort of equal to the sum from m equals to 1 to infinity of 2 times minus 1 to the m plus 1 over m sine of mx. Kind of cool. You've written x as function of squiggly lines, and you could do this with any function now. But just one little remark. So why did I write squiggly line? Because it turns out if you have a very strange function, this Fourier series might diverge everywhere. So there is a function whose Fourier series is infinity everywhere. So we don't get inequality. But here's a fact. If f is continuous, then we do get equality. Quality. So this sarcastic equal is an equal. And also, if f has a jump at a, let's say something like that, this is f and this is a, then the Fourier series equals to the average of the jumps. Then we get equals to, I guess, f of a plus f of a minus over 2. So if this is f of a plus, this is f of a minus, and then we get this is the jump. F of a minus plus f of a plus over 2. So if someone asks you, you know, to which function does this Fourier series converge to, whenever it's continuous, it's your function. But whenever it has a jump, it's just the average of the jumps. All right, and that's all for now. I will do another extra special, if you want, about cosine and sine series, and particularly. But if you really like that, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching the orthogonality extravaganza. I hope you had a fun time.